Morning, it's Vlogmas day 3. I have been up since 6 o'clock. It is just about to be 7. I'm editing yesterday's vlog. I know I usually start these opening my advent calendars, but they're currently on the floor, but I'll do that in a little second. Just gonna concentrate on getting this done. Spent the last 15 minutes watching back our engagement video again, and every time I watch it, it makes me cry happy tears. And when I tell people about it, I talk about the moment it happened, I always get like overwhelmed with emotion. So yeah, thank you still for all the lovely comments we're getting, all the love everyone's sending. It's just, we're all just so happy, and it's nice to have so much love coming our way. I'm very excited about India. I'm not sure what to expect. I know it will be a culture shock. Our last trip, this is crazy. We've done a year's worth of activity, and I think the first trip was in April. I've actually, funny enough, since Vlogmas last year, I have been vlogging my entire year. I just haven't done anything with stuff yet, but in our Budweiser collective, there is a whole group of us. Originally it was 10, now there's 8. There's people from Canada, America, China, and Zoe and I from England. I think we're going to be learning to DJ, so Zoe has the upper hand. She already knows how to DJ. I think we're doing a little bit of tourist stuff. Like when we went to Vietnam, that was amazing. We did Halloween there, but we did have 2 days of doing tourist stuff, which I really appreciated. Because when I go on these trips, I don't always necessarily see where I'm going when it's with work. To think our bill for internet is going up, but our upload speed is so bad. Are you actually kidding me? Let's get into number 3. Some baubles. This one is a little delicate teardrop charm. A coconut oil conditioning shampoo. I will give this to Paul. He, as I have said before, it's like he drinks his shampoo and conditioner. He goes for it very quickly, so this can be for him. What is the largest rainforest in the world? And it is the Amazon. It wants me to compliment 5 people. It will make their day. This smells so incredible. I'm guessing this is soap. The only trouble when it comes in these things is it doesn't tell you what it is. Maybe it says it on the back. I'll double check. It does have a list of what's inside, but it's not like it is on day 3. It's this. So I still don't really know what it is. I'm guessing it's one of the smaller things down here. Maybe it's the mango soap. I don't know. If you guys know what that product was, can you tell me what it was? 3 is over here. The Kiehl's Hydro Plumping Retexturizing Serum Concentrate. There's so many things around at the moment, which is like retexturizing, and what is retexturizing? Obviously I'm going away, so I am not able to bring those with me. So when I come back, I'm gonna have a lot to open. It is tea time. I can't start the day without a nice cup of tea. I'm not really a coffee person in the morning, because I swear that just makes my tummy like not happy. So a good old cup of tea. Tetley is my tea of choice. My parents do a really nice tea where they mix a Tetley tea bag and an Earl Grey tea bag. That's actually really nice. I used to have 1 sugar, now it's more like half a sugar. Oh my god, let me show you the fridge. Let me show you how empty it is. It's looking a little bit more full because mum gave me this. It has some melon in and some lychee. She also gave me a Sharon fruit. I don't even know what this thing in the back is. I think it might be some chili paste my dad gave Paul. Is it wrong if later on for lunch I have the leftover Nando's from the other day? That was Vlogmas day 1, wasn't it? What's in here? I'm not even sure what's in there. It might be the halloumi cheese that we used before we went away. And then we have our milk. Lactose-free milk. I did before have almond milk, soy milk. Just wasn't quite the same. Just a splash of milk. There we go. Actually, a bit more. There we go, lovely cup of tea.
So noodles for breakfast. I didn't fancy having toast today, so.
But I'm on my phone, I'm checking messages. So I'm still getting a few messages about our engagement, so I'm replying to those. And also I need to reply to comments on my video as well. But again, thank you so much to everyone. It really does put a massive smile on our faces. Finally, it's 10:30. How long have I been trying to do this? And now it can go live. I need to respond to my comments from my Vlogmas day 1 and also Vlogmas day 2. This has only just gone up, and yes, get in there, first comment.
I've only just put the heating on, you can hear the boiler now. I can't feel my feet or my fingers. I probably should have put that on when I woke up this morning, but gonna have my leftover Nando's for lunch. Probably should have done some sort of food shop because we have literally, as you saw in the fridge, no food. Love a cup of tea. Let's do this.
Just put all my parcels out around me for the thumbnail. But now, let's actually get around to open them. So I'm going to bring you guys closer so you can see. Feeling much warmer now. Heating is on. I've had a hot shower. Had a cup of tea. Which one should we go for first? Okay, quite like, look at the red shiny one. These things are from Pure. I went to Paris with them earlier this year. One of their foundations is one of my all-time favourites. Really good coverage. It's paraben-free, mineral oil-free, all of those good things. I think it's also vegan-friendly as well. So this is part of their Quick Pro collection. This is the press releases we usually get with products, so we have more information, prices, also release dates and stuff like that. The two items, oh my god, these glitters look so pretty. So these are the Pure Quick Pro glitters. There are five colors here. These are a five-piece eye polish kit. So glitters for your eye. You can put them wherever you want, I'm sure. This is their highlighting palette. Oh, it is beautiful. Inside, I don't know if I start swatching and just covering myself, but maybe I'll just swatch one color for now. Are they quite like a lot of them? I'm gonna do twilight. Little swatch there. I just like all the pretty colored ones first. This is Beauty Blender. I haven't actually used one of these for a while. I have quite a few of these now. This is a little cute orangey one. Next is from Rock and Rose. There's some jewelry things in here. Nice little packaging for this. As I open these things, I create piles. I've got a pile of jiffy bags I'm going to reuse, a pile of recycling, a pile of products. I have two headscarves. So this blue one I think will go really nicely with my hair. And then I have a red one. I'm not sure if red really goes. I kind of think it either clashes well or it doesn't really go. But maybe for Christmas. You can tie them either in your hair or around your neck. I'm loving this style of jewelry at the moment. I'm seeing it all over Instagram. They're so delicate. And then my Chinese zodiac is a snake, so I thought that was very fitting. And I can wear these both together. And I can stagger them as like layered necklaces. And then the last item from Rock and Rose is this amazing sterling silver rose ring. Wow, look at that. That is stunning. These are nude sticks. The artist box contains six custom created lip shades by six leading beauty, lifestyle, social media gurus with a combination of 3.6 million. Jesus Christ. I recognize at least two of these people. So these are the people that created it. The nude sticks creators palette retails for £59. It includes a mirror and pencil sharpener. This is available from Cult Beauty, Space NK, Fenwick on Bond Street. The package looks like, has a cardboard sleeve, and there is this black metal tin. And inside there are the six lip pencils and the sharpener as well. These colors are nice. I want to try this at some point. If I don't have as many things, I would kind of go more in depth and try and swatch them and stuff. But I think I might take a few of these away with me to India. I quite like the look of these colors. Oh, this is from Smashbox. This is their Create and Transform Masterclass Palette Limited Edition. Grab it whilst it's hot. This is available for 7 days from the 1st of December. Only £35 or £70. Of course, so there's different ones in it. It has 16 eyeshadows, 6 lipsticks, 2 blushes, 1 contour, bronzer, highlight. Ooh, we have some Glam Glow. I love Glam Glow face masks. Paul loves them too. He knows the brand name. This is their Glam Glow Super Mud. Oh, I need to open this and check which one this is. Oh my god, it's our favorite one. Oh, this is amazing. This face mask does wonders to pull out all of like the crap in your pores, especially like on my nose is a problem area. I've gone through 2 tubs of this, so yes, thank you very much. I will be using this along with Paul a lot in days to come. If I don't use this when I come back from India, please remind me. And then there is also the Matte Glow Moisturizer. It's so identifiable, that smell. Oh my god, that is so cute. I don't know how to pronounce this brand, so I'll just like show it to you. They make amazing hair care. And in this box, There's loads of little cute things.
Little pins. Oh my god, there's loads of pins. The first three pins. Some more pins we have. Oh my god, I'm not gonna lie. I saw that and I was like, excuse me. But it's a hairband. Wow, I have a dirty mind. Jesus Christ. We got some slippers. Found another pin. A t-shirt. Dealer. Ooh, what is this? Party proof makeup. Stay all day foundation and concealer. Are you all of the things free? I need to double check if they are like paraben free and all that kind of stuff. This is what the product looks like. Foundation and concealer. They have sent me shade 3 light. So in the top we have the concealer. I feel that's quite warm tone for me. It has a little mirror at the top as well, which is very handy. Pull this bit off, take this bit out, and then you push. Ooh, okay, you push down and the foundation comes out. If you want a sheer natural look or full and flawless, it'll stay put and last up to 12 hours. I kind of want to put that to the test because my face gets quite oily and things don't always last on me. I have more Stila products. Oh, I love a little set. 3 stay all day liquid lipsticks, which are £20 each for these sets. They have it in Play It Cool, Warm and Fuzzy, and Sheer Delight. So those are the different sets that they have. And I have 2 myself. The Sheer Delight Stay All Day Liquid Lip Set in these little colours. Play It Cool as well. Right, my camera is flashing its battery at me. It does not like filming in one go. I only have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 left. Let's see how long we go. I speed up maybe. From Lancome we have, so there's lip products and there's also concealer. Here I have 2 of their foundation sticks. I believe these retail for £25.50 each. For the lip products, they retail for £21 each. And then I have these 3 beautiful shades here. These are available in 14 different shades and they have different finishes. So they have gloss cream, gloss sheer, and gloss matte finishes. Ooh, balm products. I love the balm. And eyeshadow palette. This is foiled again. And then we have, ooh, it's a different highlighter. This is the Bonnie Lou highlighter. I was definitely a fan of the Mary Lou, but it's more of a warm tone highlight. Ooh, oh my god, look. Look at these shades. There are some beautiful mattes here and then shimmery ones. Oh my god. You know it's a good parcel when I react like that. I did not expect that, okay? Are you kidding me, guys? I have a parcel from Jo Malone. That was me trying to rush and go through this quickly, but wow. Oh my god, that's so generous. Look, I have 2 fragrances and a candle. The packaging, well, as you can guess, that my camera died, bad news, but I've been charging it, good news, and more good news is Paul's back.
Hello world.
How was it? Tell us about it all.
It was tiring.
They good? Were they nice?
I didn't really speak to them, to be honest. I said hello. Spoke more to their mates and the team behind them. I just sort of had to wait around and not do a lot while they were DJing. So I drank beer and now I'm feeling a bit fragile.
I went to bed really early. And then this morning I watched our engagement video and I cried. Happy tears.
That's good.
And you just watched Vlogmas, didn't you?
Yeah.
Like it?
Yeah, it was good. It was good. Very good.
And back to what I was going on about. Wow, that timing. Did you hear that burp? Oh dear, Paul.
That was not me.
Anyway, I was talking about my amazing box from Jo Malone. And oh my god, what did you eat? And I haven't smelled it yet. I've been... Oh my god, Paul, what is wrong with you? It's the Velvet Rose and Oud. I'm saying that right. Have you got hiccups?
Yeah.
Are you going to hiccup throughout the rest of this bit?
I'm trying not to.
Oh god. Oh, I can kind of smell... but... it's like a sweet, musky rose. But I don't want to take the packaging off because this looks really pretty. So for now, I'm just going to keep it like this. 2 cologne fragrances. Nectarine, Blossom and Honey. Peony and Blush Suede. I'll let Paul smell these as well. And the last box.
but on the first day of Christmas, Nails Inc. gave to me.
Could you do me a big favour?
What's that?
Can you chuck a blanket on me?
Oh, I'm not doing the blankets.
There's one there.
You can kill it yourself. I'm busy.
Please.
No.
I've got like...
You're hungover, so it's self-inflicted.
I'm not hungover, actually. I'm just tired.
What is this?
Put that on me. That'll warm me up.
I'm going to wrap Paul up.
But you can't move while I film, because that's going to be really noisy. Whilst I have you here, you can let me know which one you prefer the smell of. This one is nectarine blossom and honey.
Mmm.
And this one is peony and blush suede.
Mmm.
What one do you prefer?
The blush spray.
This one?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll put this one on then. Can you smell it?
Now that Paul is happy, we can carry on. There is a lot in here. The mini mask reef gift set. So this is a load of the different masks. The fairy tale of good skin, a new chapter.
And look at all of these. Cute.
Sparkle like a unicorn, the beauty gift set. Face mask, there's also a lipstick and two nail varnishes. And I can see that because it said on the back just there. This is the Prosecco Made Me Do It gift set. There are two nail varnishes in this set and there's also a makeup bag. The Sparkle Baby Nail Polish Bauble. So you can give your friend a bauble and there is a glittery polish inside.
Sold.
I can't believe how much stuff is in here. This is crazy. The Wishes and Kisses Nail Polish set. I'm loving this shade. That's so, so pretty. The Rock Around the Nail Polish Tree, this festive season gift set. The Jelly Shot. Oh, I think I saw these before. Oh my god, look at this. So this is a lipstick. And can you see there's like a flower in the bullet? That's so pretty. Doesn't smell of anything. It's called X Revenge. Lip balms, I believe. This is a green one with a flower. Because my lips are really dry. And my dry lips have just ruined that. That is everything. I hope you enjoyed. I will show you my piles that I have neatly done. And that was a lot of packaging. If I show you the items that was from it, that was a lot of packaging. These are all the items that were in the boxes and all the packaging. This is my pile of recycling. Those are the Jiffy bags, all nice and put together tidily. And then a pile of rubbish. That's so much for that though. I thought I would try one of the new sticks. I've just gone for Baby K. That's what it looks like on. Quite like it. I usually don't like wearing a lipstick when I don't have other makeup on because I just think it looks weird, but this color is really nice. Mm-hmm. What do you think to this color?
Yeah, wonderful.
Great feedback. All packed up. I packed really quickly. I basically just shoved a load of outfits in there. I have way more than I need. It's actually not too heavy, but I can just decide what I want to wear whilst I'm in India. Instead of putting all the stuff away in my studio, I've just put it under the tree, so we don't need fake presents. I've just got all of my booger mail.
And you know what? I don't mind. It usually looks quite nice. I'd like mind with all your makeup laying everywhere, but you've done a good job there.
I've placed it nicely.
Yeah. It looks like something displayed in Gerald's or something.
Ooh. It'll be a good flight because Budweiser treat us good. We are flying business class. I'm going to appreciate that a lot. I'll either work or sleep, but I definitely need to get some sleep because I land in India in the morning. Yeah, are you going to miss me?
Yeah.
Yeah. Excuse how bad this lighting is, but Paul just told me a story and I wanted him to share it with you guys because it's actually really funny.
Had a long day yesterday and DJed until, 3, 4 in the morning? I kept falling asleep every time we were like, you know, waiting for something. I'd just fall asleep outside the tube stop or whatever. And then when we were on the bus, I happened to fall asleep. And I was sitting on the seats above the wheel, so quite high up. Kieran was against the window and I think he was dozing too, or he might have been browsing on his phone. But I proper fell asleep and I must have been doing this like left and right as the bus was going around. Next minute, I'm waking up on the floor, like completely face planted the floor, asleep. And it didn't hurt at all. And the only reason I sort of knew is because this woman just went, oh my god, and it kind of like woke me up. So like even the the impact didn't even wake me up. It was kind of like, you know when you wake up and you feel like you're falling, that feeling.
Well, you were actually falling.
That's so funny though, I actually...
Just waiting to get picked up now. Thought I would show you my airport attire. I like to be comfortable. No makeup, obviously I still have the lip product on. But I got my Converse on, some joggers. I usually just wear a strappy crop top, but it's quite cold here, so I have that on underneath. And then a long sleeve nude top. All Saints jacket. I just like to be, yeah, super comfy. Being picked up in a fancy Mercedes. Thank you, Budweiser.
Now arrived, I'm at Terminal 2. That took around 3 hours. Now, let's go check in.
Wandered over to Air Canada's lounge, and on the signs it said it was like a 15-minute walk. It literally was more like a 5 to 10-minute walk. Really not very far. Here, this is a nice lounge. I'll like try and walk around and tour, but I feel really conscious filming. I'm being really quiet now. I feel really conscious filming when there's people. Like, this lounge isn't very busy, but I am getting so many weird looks today. I think it's because I've got my glasses on, so I'm more like aware of people looking. I don't have company, so I'm not distracted, so I keep noticing how many people look at me weirdly, and it's making me feel so self-conscious. Then went into the bathroom to look in the mirror to check there was nothing up, because I was like, why am I getting so many weird looks? I think it's just the hair. That is a usual thing, but yeah, it made me feel a bit paranoid. Stupid camera battery is flashing at me already. But luckily, I remembered to bring my charger so I can charge whilst I eat. I'm in the lounge. It's really quiet in this area, hence I'm sat here. There's like magazines, there's like bar stools, tech area through here. I may go up a few times, but first time around I've gone for an orange juice. This is like chicken in maple sauce or something. Rice and green beans. And then through this door over there, there's toilets and there's even showers. And there is so much food. There's like a bar as well. I didn't want to film when I was in there because there was people on them. They were just looking for what we were doing. But it's just like a buffet. Just help yourself.